Lord Mystery and the Secret Behind Nonverbal Hypnosis and Mesmerism. Results of my researches for your personal development, for your life, and for becoming a professional with the highest results.
Basta. Quelli che riescono ad entrare, non tutti.
Dai, c'è poi il sedersi.
Questa qua. Seconda. Chiudi, chiudiamo la porta.
Sì, che piano metti? 5.
Fissa.
Non so se esistiamo. Massimo 3 persone sarebbe.
Cresce.
Allora uscite. Guarda, guarda i suoi gli occhi, sempre i suoi. Come ti chiami?
Maria.
Giovanna. Come ti chiami? Giovanna.
Che bellonetto.
Com'è andato?
Bene.
Posto?
Sì.
Bene, bene, rilassata, sembra
è andata bellonita.
Racconta la tua esperienza.
Niente, riguardando lo specchio, è stata una cosa abbastanza rapida entrare.
Poi ho guardato e quando ti ho chiesto il tuo nome, come ti chiami adesso? Come ti chiami?
Il mio nome lui è singhiozzato.
Non so se sono segnali non verbali.
Sì.
E cosa significa, Max?
Cosa significa?
Chiudi.
Spengo? Spengo?
Sì.
Thank you.
la tua esperienza?
Niente, guardando lo specchio è stata una cosa abbastanza rapida entrare.
If I should say, what is important is not to conceptualize. This discipline is not for people that overthink. If you are overthinker, don't do magnetism. Do something else. Don't do either hypnosis. Do something else. People that read too much books and do too few practice cannot practice adequately. Why? For a simple reason. Because this discipline is non-verbal. Non-verbal means that it's not based on words. And if you use words, you are starting on a false ground. You must start non-verbal. It means being conscious of your body. Stop the overthinking of your mind and you will get a lot of results. You will get even a lot of results in your life, because overthinking is the first cause of problem in our life. We have 50,000 thoughts each day, but how much are useful? Our discipline, learn to change your life and to have a safer and healthier approach to the world. The first element that brought me interest in this discipline was the case. Virgilio, a mysterious man living in countryside, was able to hypnotize in seconds. Another person that I met, I searched for him because I searched everywhere people being able to fascinate, to hypnotize, what was Erminio di Pisa. Erminio di Pisa, that was interested in personal growth, in esotericism, in also was very able to heal people. Professor Erminio di Pisa, was able to heal a person in a few seconds because he had a very strong gaze, and with this gaze, he created a transformation in the person. The very first time I saw him, I didn't expect it. Di Pisa had introduced me to a small private TV broadcast that were there, and he was there and was a technician that had pain on his back. At this point, Di Pisa tell him, "Professor, look at me." And in a moment, he put away the pain. I was astonished. The guy was okay. After I tried by myself to repeat what I had seen, and after I asked the guys, I asked many elements to Di Pisa in order to repeat it. Now I teach this technique in my house. And many of my students get very strong results with the gaze. In some way, we reset the mind. And I give you a very simple exercise to do, to exercise your gaze, is learning not to blink. You can do it with a dot on a wall. You try to observe a dot and not to blink. You stay like this. If you observe, even me, in this video, I didn't blink. And you try to observe the point without blinking. Even Di Pisa did this exercise. You can do this exercise even with a mirror. And this I will explain in another video.